Good morning, dear children. Welcome again to the Google Classroom of Sri Gokula Public School, Gurvayur. I am Lisa, your physics teacher. Let's memorize what all things we have discussed in the previous class. Yes, we have discussed that force can change the state of motion. Force can change the shape of an object. And with the help of examples and pictures, we have understood its effects of force. Now that we have got a better understanding of what is force, now let us talk about various types of force. So the first type of force is contact force. So the name itself, it defines contact. That means when the object is in direct contact, it is said to be contact force. Let me give you an example, muscular force and frictional force. These are the two examples of contact force. Now, let us look at some common examples which help you to understand what is the meaning of direct contact.
Now let us look at common examples which help you to understand what is the meaning of direct contact. So here if you see who is applying the force. This person is applying the force on the object. If you see here, the hands of the person are in direct contact with this object. So this is the example of contact force. Now what type of force is being applied? The person is applying force, but the force is applied by which part of the body? It is being applied by his muscles. So this is a muscular force. Let us look at another example. The girl is lifting a bucket. So she is definitely applying some force. So here again, you see there some contact with an object. So this is also example of contact force. Animals. Animals also make use of muscular force to carry out their physical activities and other tasks. Animals like bullocks, horses, donkeys and camels are used to perform various tasks for us. In performing this task, they use muscular force. So the force resulting due to the action of muscles is known as muscular force. Since muscular force can be applied only when it is in contact with an object, is called a contact force.
Now let us talk about another contact force, friction. What is friction? The force that opposes motion. Now what do you mean by opposes? That means something which tries to prevent motion. And motion means it's all about movement. So when an object is moving, we say that the object is in motion. Now if there is a force which is trying to stop the movement of that object, that force is called friction. Let me give you one example. Suppose you have a toy car. So as you push the toy car, what happens? The car starts to move and after a while it stops. Now why the car stops? You did not stop it. You just gave some force because of which it started moving. But it came to rest on its own. It is due to friction. Because there was a frictional force between the surface and wheels of the car. So due to this frictional force, the frictional force is trying to oppose motion and is trying to slow down the movement. Let us take another example.
Now let us discuss some other examples. A ball rolling along the ground gradually slows down and finally comes to rest. When we stop pedaling a bicycle, it gradually slows down and finally comes to a stop. Similarly, a boat comes to rest if we stop rowing. In all this situation, no force appears to be acting on the objects. Yet their speed gradually decreases and they come to rest after some time. What causes a change in their state of motion? Could some force be acting on them? Can you guess the direction in which the force must be acting in each case? The force responsible for changing the state of motion of objects. In all this example is the force of friction. It is the force of friction between the surface of the ball and the ground that brings the moving ball to rest. Similarly, friction between water and the boat brings it to a stop once you stop rowing.
The force of friction always acts on all the moving objects, and its direction is always opposite to the direction of motion. Since the force of friction arises due to contact between surfaces. So, this was all about friction. So, I conclude today's session. Students, we have discussed about contact force. We have seen the example of contact force, muscular and frictional force. So, dear students, I have attached the URL video and notes to the classroom. So, please all of you attend the test paper and post it. See you in the next class. Till then, bye.